Yeah, so I carry on with those technical thing. Dancers doing because do it because they are performing, of course. So you need to keep certain shape. For example, as you know, I don't particularly practice at all nor play at the moment. So if I want to go faster or be easier. But the funny thing is a bit like a driving bicycle, you don't really lose. So here's my G scale. I'm trying to evaluate how much I lost. Well, I didn't lose very much. I would need a little practice to be better, but I'm basically not doing much of those things anymore because I did a lot. It's so many exercises out of it. They're all made to make you forget about technique, not think about it. So I can break those intervals, you know. If I go up a diatonic, it goes, but I can go 1, 3, 2, 4, and I can go also this down. All those things are scales, but I can also take this highest strings I have, the first string, and try to go up only on these strings. I have to slide on every time I have to move my hand position to reach those notes. There's all kind of things. Another thing which is much more musical and I use are arpeggios. Arpeggio are the intervals who design a tonality, a chord. For example, I'm trying to give you a very simple example. If I take G major, so it goes the same G but minor. I made a little oops because I was thinking where to put this one note in the middle, on the third string or on the here, or which is another string change. There's all kind of things like this, and then you can do it in every tonality. So the G was like quite, but I can do everything in A flat. If you stick to position of the hand, it will be of course the same position, but a semitone, one fret up. But if you start not to do this, but think in this scale or in this tonality, then of course it will bring you a lot of different things. So I'm going to play a bit on this G. If I play now in A flat, I might just look for the notes and not look for positions or those kind of fixed element that you can move like math. I go A flat. And then thinking only of the notes, my fingers. That's why you will have to have technique, is because my fingers are going to be forced to go in strange fingerings. But as I think about the note and follow only my ID from the note, my technique will somehow follow. I won't have a problem to reach this note, even it's not the most geometric position of hands. I don't know if this is helping you anyhow. You don't do things like this with writing, I guess, no? Well, I can't imagine you do pages of later A, then later B, then before writing anything. Or do you? Something like same way I talk to you.